Hi, everyone. This is Daryl Lonnie with the head coach of the Wolves, Arne Ferguson. Well, let's start with last week's game, Eastern Washington. Your comments on the loss in Spokane, Arne?
A tough loss. Game that we felt we were in all the way through until maybe that last drive where defensively we really couldn't get the ball back to our offense. And it started out with 6 minutes and it came all the way down to round two or something like that. Until then, our offense was moving the ball. Our special teams, especially our punt return, was really getting our offense great field position. And defensively, we were doing well against the run other than one huge play on the first play of the game, and then three or four pass plays that were big. If we could have contained those, things would have been really much different. But we felt good about how well our kids competed physically. And speed-wise, they had a couple guys that can really run that we need to match. So I didn't quite get that done.
You've got a couple of touchdowns called back. That's always a killer. It seems like teams that get touchdowns called back more often lose than not. And then you had another situation. You weren't very lucky, and I know you had an open receiver. The ball goes off his hands. It's deflected. They wind up with an interception, which I believe it was 21-14 at that time. Right. They score on a short drive, which really helped Eastern.
Yeah, I think that happened probably around the 20, 25, somewhere in there. So it's a really short field position and sudden change where we got to keep them to a field goal, not a touchdown, and didn't get that done. And then later in the game, we had a touchdown up the sideline. We really felt the receiver was pushed out of bounds, came back inbounds, and caught a touchdown pass that they took away, saying he went out on his own. It's a hard corner that's jamming. And so we didn't see that, and still don't see that on film. So that took away some momentum. And then there's one time we were in the red zone where we got a holding penalty that moved us back out of that field goal range or touchdown range a little bit. But other than that, we're moving the ball extremely well, I thought. In between getting down to the 20, we just need to finish more. And a couple of those were things that we created could do better, and one was out of our control. You know, that ball that's tipped, you know, those things do happen, and defense, we got to step up and do a better job, keep to a field goal.
Listeners would want me to ask the question, you played a level up. Mm-hmm. Eastern Washington's a level up. Why do you play team a level up?
We strongly feel that Division II and 1AA, when you play against the high caliber teams, are very comparable. You know, last year, for example, Central Washington was a playoff team. They lost to Montana, who I believe played in the final game of the playoffs or close to it, by 3 points. So even though they're level up, huge amount of difference financially in scholarships, there's no question about that. But that's the level you got to be at to be successful at Division II. So our players need to be in those games. I always like to play them early to really see what our players can work on. So the progress from first week to second week going into Humboldt is really what we're going to evaluate.
Humboldt State, very good quarterback, returns. Mike Pruitt, very good receiver, 6'5", Matt Smith. Talk about these guys.
And Matt's not the only receiver. You know, we feel that they have always had very good skill guys. Being the only Division II school in the whole state of California, we're the only Division II school in Oregon. But with California, obviously quite a bit bigger than Oregon, they're able to draw and attract some athletes. The Division II is a good fit for them. So they're skilled kids, we've always felt can really do some things. And he's not the only one. But he's a Portland State transfer that left for whatever reason that really think that he's going to be one of the top receivers you'll face all year. Their quarterback, we know that they've had situations back and forth, but it's a new year. Really expect him to get going. Haven't seen film on him yet, so excited to do that. And they have also extremely good offensive line, especially in the interior side, that we have a lot of respect for.
They have a running back, Bobby Thomas, back at a big game Saturday at Adams Day.
He's from a JC down there. Expect him to be extremely good. They've always had two or three real good running backs. And so we'll see on that. Defensively, I know they only have a couple really good players, a safety that's a real good player, and also a linebacker. Those are the main ones back. But they rotated a lot of guys in last year, so we don't expect much different than we faced last year. So we expect to be a great game down there.
Reynolds is the linebacker. Ricker Dooley is the safety that you're talking about. A long trip. Kind of a disadvantage, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, anytime you get on the bus and, you know, you got to work the kinks out of your legs, our kids want to play. You know, it's a great atmosphere. We play at 6:05, I believe, or 6. It's a nice atmosphere at night, good attendance. So it's always a close game down there, the first time we played in the last 3 or 4 years. So nothing's taken for granted. We got to find a way to get our first win of the season.
I would ask you what time you get back on Sunday morning, but I don't think I want to.
No. I've even debated about changing our games we play them tonight just so they have one time feel the the pain of getting back and preparing. It's really not that week getting back. It's that next week that you're playing that throws you in a curve. So luckily we're at home with Dixie the following week. So
that's the head coach of the Wolves, Arne Ferguson.